right? And so there's a dynamic world that you live in. You know, there's an old saying in America, you know, when you're playing hockey, you don't want to be straight into where the puck is now. You want to straight to where the puck is going to be, right? You have to anticipate. And that's the one of the things, you know, entrepreneurs have to do. What the world will need 2 years out based on which way the technology is moving. Because it takes a couple of years for you to get there, right? So take your time. Don't feel rushed. Don't feel rushed. There's going to be a next opportunity, a next opportunity, a next opportunity, a next opportunity. Unless you tell me that the world is going to slow down and stop changing and stop evolving, there's no lack or dearth of new idea, new opportunity emerging. And it's much better to have another person with you, you know, with a contrarian view, somebody with a complementary set of skills than you do. So, you know, you don't want to have another partner which has the same outlook, same skills, same background, because you haven't done anything. You want somebody who sees things differently, you know, who's smart, you know, maybe a marketing guy. You know, so two of you can, you know, look at the problem from two different perspectives, right? And two of you will be better than some of two, you know, if you start to interact in a right fashion. That's how the ideas emerge. That's how the things happen. A couple of guys, you know, starting to hash out their different perspectives. But I don't know there's an algorithm possible.
So could you give us a little more information about venture capitalists? Because we are aware of banks here who charge interest for their loans. And we are also aware of government organizations like Tamil Nadu Industrial Investment Corporation who give some subsidies and things like that. Yeah. What exactly is the venture capitalist? Do they function in India? And we are aware they are there in the US, but are such groups available in India?
So the banks cannot give you the money that you cannot return. Banks hold the savings of people which are for their future, you know, their children's education, their daughter's weddings, their retirement. Then the bank need to lend money to people who are not going to lose it. Entrepreneurs are very likely to lose your money. You know, if your venture fails, the venture capitalist doesn't get a dollar back. You know, it's not a loan to you, it's an investment in you, in your company. If company doesn't go anywhere, he has lost his money. So venture capital is the money that is risk capital, is willing to assume the full risk of your venture failing, but it wants unlimited returns. It doesn't want that 5%, 7%, 10% return that banks expect. It wants to be 10 times your money back, 100 times money back if your venture succeeds. And so it's a high risk, high reward play money. Venture money comes from the people who are willing to lose it. It's a surplus capital. It's not the money that they need for their retirement. It's not the money they need for their children's education. It's not the money. See what I'm saying? So it's a surplus capital of the people who have more than plenty of money. And they want to go and play this thing. And so it's a high risk, high reward situation. So if I was doing it myself, I can do two or three such investments. And the odds of succeeding are low. I need to be doing 10, 15 of these investments before I can be reasonably sure 1, 2, 3 of these might succeed. So people pool their surplus resources into a fund, a venture capital fund. And they have some professional venture capitalists, professional fund managers manage it into 15, 20, 25 companies. So they have spread, spread the risk around 25. And the theory is that if you invest in 20 companies and if 19 of them fail and one succeeds and it makes 50 times its money, you come out ahead, right? So venture capital is a high risk, high reward money, and so it's not the money itself, it's the money and the smarts that come with the money from the people who are giving you the money. Government money, I don't want to say too much. it's a dumb money. Venture capital is a very smart money. It's a very smart money, you know, and they're going to, you know, thoroughly evaluate you, thoroughly evaluate the market that you are going to play in. You know, they will have to be reasonably convinced that they can make 10 times at least, you know, maybe hopefully 20, 40, 50 times their money, you know, if you were to succeed, knowing full well that you will fail more often than not.
Sir, what do you think actually lacks in Indian entrepreneurs for not getting very global?
What's that?
What do you think which lacks in Indian entrepreneurs for not going global? Like maybe...
The Indian entrepreneurs are going global all the time. Look at Bharti. They own most of the Titan stuff in Africa.
Very specifically, if Facebook was started in India, I don't think that would have been...
Facebook will not start in India anytime soon. Facebook will not start anywhere except in America. Because there's a very well-developed ecosystem in America. You know, why hasn't things like that happened in Germany or Japan or England, let alone India, right?
Rediff and all were started in India, but they weren't very famous globally as Google was.
So there is a ecosystem of players. You know, the entrepreneurs, the venture capitalists, the angel investors. You know, the entrepreneurial customers. One of the reasons things like iPod or iPhone worked is large number of American customers or entrepreneurial customers. They're willing to buy defective or less than complete products, to give entrepreneurial opportunity. It took a long time before we saw the iPhone emerge from iPod, right? And so you have this whole ecosystem in America of the venture capital, angel investors, entrepreneurs, customers, employees who are willing to come and work at the startups at substandard salaries. Yeah, India will get there, but not in my lifetime.
Sir, another question. What was your motive in setting up schools of information technology?
Hold it closer.
What was the motive which driven you to set up schools of information technology? Because my name is Praneet, and if I'm going to set up Praneet School of Information Technology, that would be only for my fame.
I was paying back my debt to society. My IIT education was by and large free. At the end, I said, I would have been nobody for my IIT education. I want the next set of students to have the same opportunity that I had. So I was just paying my debt back to society with interest.
Sorry for the question, and thank you.
Yeah.
Actually, I think that last comment was a good message to our students also. So when you get jobs, please give back to your alma mater. I have one question. I think during lunch you mentioned that the future of India's growth is going to be in the hands of the entrepreneurs. What do you think IITs can do to ensure that our students, if they do go out and become entrepreneurs, that they're good entrepreneurs? I mean,
I think IITs are doing a damn good job already. As we have seen, the IITs have provided a very competitive environment. One of the things I remember at IIT was a very humbling experience. Most of us come to IIT from schools where we were used to being the top student. We are better than everybody else. And you get to IIT and it's very hard to be better than anybody else. Everybody else is just as good. So that's the first time in life you are an average student, right? And so there's a competition to get even slightly better, and that competition is what serves you well, because you need to show that you're slightly better than the other guy. And the other guy is just as competitive, right? So I think the point I made is the future of India is entrepreneurship, simply because the problem with India is poverty. Poverty of immeasurable suffering and all that, right? The antidote to poverty is new wealth in society. Unless you have oil, or even I don't know if that really works. The new wealth is by and large produced by entrepreneurs. you know, and the, when entrepreneurs start to succeed, it produces a huge amount of new wealth in society. You know, thousands of people get employed, and you know, and they, you know, they employ others. You know, they, it sort of the word is trickled down, but it does that very effectively and very rapidly. So for India to succeed, if 2% of the population becomes entrepreneurs, and on average they hire 20 people to 25 people, half the people will get employed. There's no alternative method that I'm aware of where you can create that many jobs that quickly. So the national policy has to be, you know, encourage entrepreneurship on a large scale. We don't know which 2% will succeed. So everybody has to try, so that these 2% winners will emerge. I would have never bet on myself as an entrepreneur. My family history is army. By the way, my unscientific search has shown in US, the Indian entrepreneurs by and large come from the army families in India. You know, IIT education in army family, you know, is Vinod Khosla, Sabir Bhatia, Arjun Malhotra. You go down the list. You go down the list, you know, myself. You know, for some reason, you know, there was the army connection in the family and IIT education. It gave you the, you know, the discipline and the knowledge. You know, so you need to be very competitive. You need to be restless. You know, you need to excel. IITs are doing a damn good job. You know, now I see, you know, there are incubators everywhere, and you know, which is sort of exposing the entrepreneurs to the idea of becoming entrepreneurs. You know, people like me have become visible role models. So I don't know if, you know, if the problem is at IIT's. Problems are in Delhi. Yeah, they haven't woken up to the fact that, you know, they need to be enabling the entrepreneurship in the nation at a large scale. You know, the policy framework is very, very bad, very, very bad. They're still stuck at half in Indians, you know, Narendra money, you know, 100 days of make work, yeah, which is nonsense. Thank you.
We're going to try and turn Kanwal into an honorary IIT Madras alumnus by giving him a whole bunch of our mementos.
Then you give me a t-shirt, I'll wear one, baby.